So in Notion, copy and pasting in formulas works great when we're copying and pasting from a normal formula editor, but there are some problems and kind of unfinished features in the automations version of the editor, and that's what we're going to have a look at today, and I'm going to show you kind of some tips to navigate around the errors that you might get when you copy and paste a formula from the automation editor. So to start, we're going to look at some formulas as they are normally in an editor. So I've got an actions database and a logs database here, and each of my actions has attached logs. So I can go into a formula here, and I could say logs.map, for example, and maybe I want to get the created at date from those as a list. And then maybe I want to sort those and I want to get the first one. So that might be like the first log or something like that, or maybe we want the last log, and that could be January 25th, 2025. Let's save that and have a look. And that gives us our last timestamp for those logs. Now, if I have a, let's copy this formula and hit save. Now I've got a duplicate of this system down below, and it's got all of the same property names. And that means that in Notion, I can actually paste this in here and everything should work perfectly. So this is great for sharing formulas. And if I go ahead down here and I click Add Example, I can paste this formula in here and it looks quite different from what we see in our editor here. The editor has these what are called property tokens. So logs and created at, these are the names of our properties. But when we paste it, we get this thing called prop. And this is a function call in Notion formulas. And this is how it actually looks behind the scenes. Instead of that logs item that you see in the editor, you get prop logs. And here we have also got, we're calling current.createdAt, and it's also calling prop. Notion is really smart in that when we copy and paste this example into a formula, it will automatically switch those prop calls to property tokens in the visualization. So we're able to immediately grab examples from other people's stuff, even when it goes across two databases, as long as these property names match. So let's go ahead and see what happens when they don't match. So we'll get rid of this one. And let's say in our setup, logs was actually called action logs. Now, if I go ahead and I grabbed a formula from somebody, I've got the same setup pretty much, but my properties are called something different. So when I click in here to paste, you'll note that it says logs is not defined, cannot find function created, because it's not able to find logs in my database. And so it wouldn't be able to find the created at function, or the property rather, from that database. So how do we correct this? It says logs is not defined. So we need to figure out what is logs in our context. So I'm going to just select the logs function here and I'm going to swap it with action logs. Great. And now it says cannot find created. So we're going to do the same thing with created. I might just delete it. And now when I hit current dot, it's going to give me the options from that action logs database. And so we can say created at, and now we've got our working formula. So this is how we correct a simple formula from one database to another when we have a similar setup and the formula is from a formula property and not a formula in an automation. So next up, let's have a look at what this looks like in automation. So let's go ahead and we're going to create a new automation on my database here. And just to keep things simple, I'll do any property edited. Let's say we wanted to edit the property of the date. We want to change the date and we're going to pick custom formula here. And so maybe we want to edit the property of the action to the next step in based on the last log that was triggered or something like that. So we might say trigger page dot logs, and we're going to do that same formula. So we'd say logs.map, and we want the current dot created at, and from those we want the most recent one. So we're going to sort them and then call last on that. So we might want to, in this case, set a variable, and we're going to say, go back to the front here. We'll set this as the last date, comma. And there we go. The editor's a little weird here. We need to, oh no, we need to hit Shift plus Enter, and then you have to go and hit Backspace here because it's not possible to get to the front of a formula. You'll see here where when I hit the left arrow that it actually goes up to the last line. So we have to do this funny stuff to get these on the correct line here. There we go. Okay, and so this would return the last date. And this would allow me to then assign this to the property. So set date to the last date. And maybe we want to do reassign that task or something like that. So we might do something like set the date to date add. And we're going to add the, let's see, from the trigger page, we want the ordinal, which is the count of periods that we want. So 1 day, 2 days, that kind of thing. And we can also get the, let's, we need a, from the trigger page, we also need the frequency. And we'll call a lowercase on the frequency, and that will give us day, month, week. And so this should add 1 day to the last log that was generated when the properties are edited or something like that. It's kind of a trivial formula that doesn't really make any sense, but we just need an example of a formula that we can copy and paste, right? So I'm going to hit Command Copy, and we're going to save this one. And so we're setting my date to the value, and got to hit Save, enable the formula. Great. So in this case, in the formula, we're taking the ordinal and the frequency, and we're adding one. So in this case, when anything in this row is edited, we're going to add 1 day to the last date where the log was created here. So in this case, it's going to be, it'll set it to January 26, 1 day in advance. What this formula is doing is not important. We're just here to talk about copying and pasting. So let's say I wanted to share this formula with someone who also has a similar setup for me. We're going to go down here and I'm going to add another example, and we're going to paste, and we're going to see something. There is nothing being called here. Why is that? And what would happen if we go down to, say, our database? Let's see what happens if we add this into our other actions database. So we want to do when any property is edited, let's set the date, and we're going to use a custom formula, and let's paste this in here. Okay, we get a pretty substantial error here. We get something that says token, and then there's a bunch of numbers and letters here, does not match the blocks collection. And then we say token ID OJ does not match the blocks collection. So basically, these tokens, they're being replaced, and trigger page works, but it can't find dot logs, and it can't find created at, and it can't find these properties on the trigger page. And that is because copying and pasting does not really work in these. And so a lot of times you're going to see this, and this works within Notion, where I'd be able to see this. And we're going to do the exact same thing to repair this in this case. So from the trigger page, we're going to have to delete logs, and we're going to have to reselect action logs. And we probably want to select created at again, just in case. And then from the, we're still got some errors here, ID OJ. So we're guessing that that's this token, this ordinal one. Let's see if we replace ordinal with an actual reference here. Great, that replaced that one. And then we're gonna go and we're gonna replace frequency. So I just delete that and click frequency right in that slot. And now we've got a working formula again. So this is great, but this only works when you've copied internally in Notion. So how do exactly do I share this formula with someone else? So let's copy this again. I'm gonna hit save here. Maybe we'll enable this one. And let's see what happens if I go back to my examples. I'm gonna add example. And instead of just Command V, I'm gonna use the shortcut on Mac this time to paste without formatting. And we're gonna notice something very different this time. We've got our last date, and look at this. What's this? Global button page source global. And then it's calling on that, it's calling prop.actionlog. So we've got our props, right? We've got our current.prop created at, that's great. And then in our next line, we've got global button page source global again, and a third time here. It seems to be wherever that reference to trigger page was in the original formula that we've got this kind of JSON looking blobby type thing. Now, in order to share these formulas with you, you can see I can't really paste here, and I can't really copy and paste here either. So neither of these would be useful as a documentation thing. So, but this does actually have all the information we need on it to correct this formula. We're going to look at my little guide here, and I'll share this guide in the YouTube video and in this video to be able to map the properties that you're looking for from these JSON tokens. This is a JavaScript notation token. So you'll see here the name of the token that we're actually going to be looking for. So in my case, it was what, trigger page? You can see that it copies as global button page source global. So each of these is source global, and each of these has a corresponding global name. And so you can see here that if you see your formula copy and paste as global today, that means it's a date triggered property. If you see it as page creator, that means it's a page creator property, and so on and so forth. And some of these are duplicated. We've got whoever clicked and whoever triggered are both current user. And the only one that's kind of breaks this convention is the page added property token, which gives you an action ID, and there's going to be a custom action ID. And this is actually the ID of the Notion automation itself. So you'll know that you need to swap out this big old string. So basically everything in between these brackets, the curly brackets, you're going to replace with page added. So how would this actually look if I were to implement this in one of mine? So I'm getting a formula. I'm going to copy this function here, and we're going to go and we're going to add it to, let's just add it to our example here. Don't really need this one, so we'll delete this. We'll do it from scratch so you can see the whole thing. New trigger. Any property edited, we're going to edit that. We want it to edit that date, right? And it really doesn't matter what this formula is. We just need to know that, you know, we're going to get some broken stuff. And it says, can't find the property, the function prop a bunch of times. Formula cannot have a return type of unknown. Allowed return type is date, because we're trying to assign a date here, right? So what we're doing right now is we're trying to call property, this prop function on this string right here. And that's not going to work because that doesn't exist. But we know we can look up that the button page global represents the trigger page, right? So I would just select this whole thing in between these brackets and including the curly braces and click trigger page, right? And now we've got prop action logs can't be found. So we need to manually replace that with logs from the trigger page, right? And then we got current.prop created at. What do we need to replace created at with? This prop call is corresponding to created at. And then we've got our next issue is expected identifier. Again, that's this problem right here. We can go look at that table and we can figure out that the button page global is representative of trigger page, and we can replace that. And because our props haven't been replaced for us, we're gonna delete this prop ordinal here, and we're gonna replace it with ordinal. And we've got one more trigger page and prop combination here. So we're gonna say trigger page. And then we've got can't find function prop, right? Because it hasn't been replaced for us. So we're gonna select frequency, we're gonna delete that. And now we know on trigger page, we need to call frequency.lower. And then we can hit save. And now our function's working. So I will share this page and you can look up these token replacements here. So if you do end up getting one of these weird looking formulas that have any of this stuff, we know we can go and look up this stuff and figure out which the operative word is. And maybe I'll even add like a name here. So we'll say text global. And this way we could say the global here is today. Action ID is what you're looking for in this one. Page creator is what we're looking for here. Button page. So this one's kind of like this trigger page where in database automations is this page is what that token is when you're clicking a button. So button page is kind of different there. When it's now, it's the time triggered. Again, button page here, it says note that this is button page, even though this is for the database automation context. Correct. They both kind of are the same, even though they're different contexts. And both of the user ones use the current user global. So I know that Notion is working on an update to this so that copy and paste will work across automation formulas. But for the meantime, if you need to remedy or repair one of your copy and pasted formulas, or you have one of these from a creator that needs to get replaced, you can do that. Because this one right here is going to be even more tricky because you don't actually know what these properties were at some point, right? So there's no real way to copy and paste and share automation formula examples that use any of these trigger page type situations, these automation tokens, which we've shown here. So hopefully this guide has been helpful. Again, this link will be linked in the description of the video, and you can also find this. You'll be able to duplicate this page potentially and utilize the automation token replacements yourself. Hope that helps.